together. I think this is a travesty. And this is sort of what's been the history of Southwest Florida with developers all along.
Vanderbilt Beach is about to look a lot different, but not everyone is too excited about it. This group protesting a new resort-style community today. The project has a big debate for months. Come Monday, county commissioners are meeting to approve the One Naples residential project.
NBC2's Brad Hamilton spoke with the protesters about why they say no time for the change.
In a last-ditch effort before the Board of County Commissioners meets on Monday, folks here with the Save the Vanderbilt Beach group met here to protest One Naples development. Now, folks here that built this wall behind me explain why they think it will be detrimental to the community.
We're here to try to keep Naples, the entire Naples, a livable place.
That 35-foot wall demonstrating the height of the proposed parking garage alone.
Does not fit with the community.
Protesters in matching shirts and masks making that message heard along Gulf Shore Road in an effort to protect their city from what they call overdevelopment.
I think this is a travesty. And this is sort of what's been the history of Southwest Florida with developers all along.
The founder of Save Vanderbilt Beach, Buzz Victor, claims that he is all in for growth in Naples.
And I'm not anti-development. Frankly, I'm not even anti-stock. I just want reasonable development.
But he is against something this big. One Naples would feature two 14-story towers, three 6-story condos, and a boat deck, which some say is just too much.
Vanderbilt Beach was never designed to be a tall building community, and he's just way, way overbuilding things.
Victor claims that thousands of residents have joined his movement to convince the county to say no to the project, saying that it will cast a shadow over other buildings in the area and create more chaotic traffic.
Literally, thousands of residents who have asked them not to. It just speaks to the fact that it's business as usual in Collier County, that the developer wins, that the residents lose.
But not everyone agrees with the Save the Vanderbilt Beach movement.
Anything that is not growing, individually, community, city, country, if you're not growing, you're dying.
Ahmed Mateo believes that the project will actually help the local economy.
I think Naples needs some stable growth, and it's about time.
The special meeting is set to take place on Monday at 9 a.m., and you can count on NBC2 to keep you up to date with the latest information. Reporting here in Naples, Brad Hamilton, NBC2.